like a stranger, like a stranger in my own hometown. I'm like a stranger, like a stranger in my own hometown. My so-called friends start being friendly. Oh, but you can't keep a good man down. No, you can't keep him. I came home with good intentions about 5 or 6 years ago. I came home with good intentions about 5 or 6 years ago. Oh, my hometown won't accept me. I just don't feel welcome here no more. About 5 or 6 years ago. When my hometown won't accept me, just don't feel welcome here no more. I'm like a stranger in my hometown. Yeah, I'm like a stranger in my hometown. My so-called friends stop being friendly. Ah, oh, but you can't keep a good man down. Pull your brains out.
Pleasant good evening, ladies and gentlemen. How do you do? This is your soul man to be with you until I get through. I want you to stand by. Don't have no fear. Following Jay's show, should I play one like this one from out of here? Elvis Presley.
Elvis's songs still get good play on Wright's program among the blues, gospel, and jazz recordings that are its staples. It was almost 40 years ago when Elvis drove down to Clarksdale from Memphis with a record and asked him to play it.
And I had been playing his record, and I had never seen him before, and I was amazed to see him. When he introduced himself to being Elvis Presley, then I went all to pieces over him. Then he and I started talking. I used to be the manager of a gospel group called the Four Star Quartet. And I could listen to a man sing a hymn. I could listen to a man sometime talk. I did that. And I could pick him out whether he could fit in my group. And talking to Elvis Presley, I could see a great future in him.
It's no accident that Wright recognized Elvis's strong gospel roots. Here at the East Trigg Baptist Church in Memphis, older members of the congregation remember Elvis joining in with the choir while in high school. These were rousing sessions led by the charismatic pastor, the Reverend W. Herbert Brewster.
Like most black people in the South, and to whose suit God has pressed down a harp of 1,000 strings, it only needed tuning. Elvis's voice was that type of voice that agreed with the thought of Calvary. He had that kind of bent and inclination and attitude that suggested that God could use him. I gave the music a different approach, a new beat. I knew that it wasn't going to hurt if I said, "Must Jesus bear the cross alone?" Well, I've said with one beat, two beat, whether I've said it high or low. And I told them, "Come on in here and put your stuff together." They came in here, and it was a glorious experience, and Elvis was in that group.
Elvis came out with a style of his own, and it was very creative. And once he got into it, and you got that feel, Elvis just took off like a late freight. And with Elvis doing this kind of music, gave an injection to black music that no other artist had ever done.
Well, soul has no color, has no barrier. But I also had a lot of good people that brought out a lot. I want to pay a tribute to a good friend of mine, Brother Elvis Presley, who opened up a lot of doors for me to get through. Elvis was a pioneer, and he came out 1 year before I did. He was out in 55, mm-hmm. Heartbreak Hotel. And then I come in 56. And Elvis and I were very good friends up until the last minute of his bodily life. But he'll always live because of the fact he was such a beautiful man. I don't care what nobody say, I know Elvis. You know, there are a lot of rumors. Elvis and I sang spiritual together. And he'd buy any movie that I'd make, any film, he'd buy the film and close the theater up and show it. I love Elvis for being a man. I love what he'd done for the people and the chance he gave me. He kept me from being number one. I was number one soul and he was number one world, and it took a long time, but it's almost like the two rental cars. Uh-huh. It made me try harder. And I love Elvis for it. And we'll always pray for Elvis.
I love him. That's my buddy, my baby. I love him. We are very good friends. And it was a very great loss to the music world. Elvis is one of the greatest performers ever lived in this world, and electrifying, elevated. Oh, he's just, you can't say enough. He's just beautiful. I love Elvis.
A man at times.
And a legend.
Oh, he was wonderful. I loved him. He was such a gentleman and all that to me, you know.
Tell me about that.
Well, when they first called, the girl said, "Elvis Presley, oh my God, what are we going to do?" I said, "Hey, it's a gig and it's a good one."
Uh-huh.
So we went, and when we got there, it was nothing like what we might have thought, you know, because it was just wonderful. Cool. It was really wonderful. He was into gospel. So every once in a while when we finished rehearsing with him, we just sing gospel, all of us, you know. And we just had a good time. He would get good money and good pay and good, it was nice atmosphere. You know, and we didn't go around with him as his friends. We worked for him. So we saw him at work or at rehearsals. So I don't know what he did in between, nor did I care. You know, mm-hmm. I just doing what I was supposed to do, and we were. So people said he was prejudiced. I said, well, I never felt his prejudice. Mm-hmm. And I don't think he was prejudiced, you know.
He treated everyone
the same. The same, yeah. He had black singers and white singers. He's at the Imperials, who was a men's group, very popular men's group. And we were the girls' group, the Spanish Expression. So
I think people have, you know, certain stereotypes about him.
I think so.
Yeah.
Because he was a wonderful person, so good-looking, you just didn't want to even look nowhere else. He was so handsome. But he was just as nice, fun. You know, he cracked jokes and all that kind of crap, and he'd be singing, and he'd make you laugh and whatnot. So we had a good time,
uh-huh.
A good run with him.
Uh-huh.
And then I left the group, and they still work with him.
Why'd you leave the group?
He's dead, huh?
Why did you leave the group?
Because my children were getting bigger, and I felt that they really needed me home. And if I had a contract on my own, so that's what I did. I went home and look for music and whatnot to sing, and then to record. And that I spent that time with my children.
And focused on developing a career as a single artist.
Mm-hmm.
When we first decided to take the gig with Elvis,
We had no idea that there would be any racial flack regarding it. Our first racial encounter was when we went to Texas. Elvis was told by his people that, well, you can leave the black girls home. You don't have to bring them. So Elvis wasn't going to do the Astrodome unless his girls could be with him. And he demanded that we be given the star treatment. We had to be in our convertible where everybody could see us and our little blonde could drive us. And that was his statement. You don't like it? Deal with it or I'm not going to be there. And I thought that was very big of him.
Elvis is an angel. Yeah, that's hot.
I thought he was a very beautiful, and still is, a very beautiful person, and his memory shall probably forever live on.
This song I'm dedicating to a really good friend of mine who have passed on, one of the greatest entertainers ever alive, one of them. He was the king. This song called Tupelo, that was his hometown, to Mr. Elvis Presley, who has passed on. That was his favorite. I hope whatever he added, he's resting in ease. Below Mississippi, there were Abbott was born. Abbott Presley, one of the greatest people who ever been born, the rock and roll king. That was my home too, right down below in Clarksdale. Tupelo is gone. Tupelo is gone. It got destroyed by the rain and wind and water.
It ain't my business what he did. Only thing I want to know, was he my friend? Did I enjoy him as a performer? Did he give the world of entertainment something? Yes, on all counts. And that's the name of that tune. You understand what I mean? Good. Because without the jazz, don't matter.
He was a bundle of energy set to music. And that echo will never die.